Welcome to another Bethel University Writing Center podcast.
I'm Jenna Ray.
And I'm Caitlin.
You know, Caitlin, the other day, I was thinking about when I was really little. I was working on a puzzle, and I was getting so frustrated because I kept trying to put the pieces in the wrong spot. And then, when I was writing my paper yesterday, I felt the same way. It was like a puzzle I couldn't solve.
You know, you're right, Jenna Ray. Organizing a paper is like putting together a puzzle. The pieces of your paper, such as the introduction, the body, and your conclusion, are like the pieces of a puzzle. If you put them in the right places, they make a beautiful picture.
We all know organization can be difficult, so here are a few ways to help you start organizing your paper. Remember, no one way is the right way. Find what works for you and stick with it.
One way to start organizing is to write down all of your thoughts, goals, and bits of research you have already done. Then, as you go through and find the commonalities between them, group them together into like areas to create your body paragraphs.
Another way to begin organizing is to create an outline of your thoughts, research, and main points. Start with your thesis and then number your topic paragraphs 1, 2, 3, etc. And under each number, write your supporting ideas for each topic.
Another way to organize your thoughts is to create a graphic organizer. Put your main idea in the middle of your page. Draw a bubble around it. From the main bubble, draw other large bubbles that represent your ideas you'll be presenting and connect them by a line to the main bubble. Draw smaller bubbles to connect your main idea bubbles and present your support. Be sure that each of the bubbles you create has an idea that directly connects to your thesis. This way, you will ensure that your paper stays within the themes you need it to.
As you begin to actually write your paper, make sure that you follow the organizer you chose. Sometimes writing your ideas down in paragraph form can be overwhelming, so here are a few tips.
Don't get stuck on the introduction. Because your introduction usually starts with broad ideas, it may be difficult to regain focus and to say what you need to say.
Sometimes starting with the conclusion can be helpful if you already know exactly what you're going to say. It will give you a good starting point and something to work towards as you write.
As you're writing, pay attention to your topic sentences and concluding sentences for each paragraph. Do they directly relate to your thesis? Do they present or summarize your evidence for this paragraph effectively?
We hope that these tips on organization have been helpful to you as you begin writing your paper. Please stop by the Writing Center if you need help in any area of your writing process.
And remember, organizing a paper is like putting together a puzzle. The pieces of your paper are like the pieces of a puzzle. When you put them in the right places, they make a beautiful picture.
Thanks for listening and have a great day.